Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Ottman. COVID-19 has brought attention to supply chain management. That's a term used to describe the businesses and decisions that turn raw materials into products that go into the hands of customers. It's also one of the hottest academic concentrations in our Jones College of Business, growing to almost 100 students in just 2 years. Joining me today to talk about this program at MTSU and the many job opportunities in this field is Professor Cliff Welborn. Well, Professor, thank you for joining us on the show. We appreciate your time.
Well, thank you for having me. I appreciate you spending the time with me today.
You hear supply chain management so much in the news because of the COVID-19 crisis that we're in. So this is going to be a good opportunity to not only talk about this academic program in the Jones College of Business, but also just about the field itself and why it's come into play. So what is supply chain management from a profession, and then how do we teach that?
So from a profession, you know, it's really just all of the steps and all of the decisions that are required to bring a product from raw materials until it gets into the customer's hands. And what we're seeing today, what we're realizing, is that supply chain, even for simple products, is very complex. There are a lot of different companies involved. Sometimes those companies are spread all across the world. So, you know, right now people are saying, how come I can't get toilet paper? Or what's the deal with meat? Supply chain is really just understanding what are all of those steps that it takes to get those products. And again, the analysis and the decisions that it takes to make that happen.
So from an academic standpoint, how do you teach that? And what does it involve to understand the mechanics of this management?
So from an academic standpoint, one of the places that we start is just understanding kind of what that chain might look like. So for us, it's a thing called process mapping, just visually mapping out all the different companies that are involved and maybe the stops along the way. So there's physical transportation. So maybe a raw material starts with one company in one country and has some processing done to it. Then it has to be transported to another company, and maybe along the way it stops in a staged warehouse for a little while, and then the second company does something to it, and then it again transports to another company, maybe sits in a warehouse for a while. So making sure students understand all these different links in the supply chain, and understanding that the reason it is called a supply chain is that if anything happens to one of those links, the chain breaks down. And that's part of what we're seeing right now, is sometimes one of those links break down and the chain stops. Part of what we do is teaching students how to analyze those situations, understand what kind of decisions they can make to help alleviate those breakdowns, and what kind of things maybe that could they do ahead of time to minimize the risk of those breakdowns. So right now, supply chain risk assessment is one of the big hot topics. You know, what could we have done to prevent shortages, and what can we do in the future to prevent shortages?
And it's been a growth major at MTSU. I was looking at the stats before we started the show that it's grown from zero, which meant it was a brand new program, to almost 100 in 2 years. That's got to be a signal not only that we're doing something that folks want to hear, but also that it's a topic that people want to explore.
Yeah, I think that's really the key. It's not so much the way we're teaching it or who the teachers are, what the class content is. That's a career field that is hot right now. So there's lots of job growth opportunities. And it's a field students are interested in because they want to know, you know, you want to help out right now. You want to be part of that solution of how do I keep materials flowing so that we can maintain our standard of living.
You mentioned some companies that we're collaborating with, that we're connected to. Can you give some folks some names so they understand who are our partners?
Sure. And that's one of the things, you know, a lot of times when people first get into supply chain, they say, well, who are the supply chain companies? So you're looking for a company name that says, you know, Johnson Supply Chain Company. And I said, I don't really find a whole lot of those. And the answer is, well, there's not a whole lot of those. Supply chain is embedded in all of the companies that you're used to. So Nissan is a huge supporter of us. Hundreds of people in their supply chain program, hundreds of people in their logistics program. So Nissan's we have a good relationship with Yoplait or General Mills right here in Murfreesboro. We have a good relationship with Yazaki, the Ingram Content Group, Dollar General, the corporate office Dollar General. So the big names of companies that you would recognize, there's always a department there that's the supply chain department that is making sure how to get the materials in so that we can process it and get them to the customer.
I knew you discussed that you've only been a formal concentration for 2 years, but we have alums who have gotten an education through the Jones College of Business who found themselves in supply chain management because of the opportunities we provided them. And they're now a network that the graduates out of this program can approach, right? That's an advantage that we have.
Yeah, that's a huge advantage. And, you know, it's not uncommon to see that. If you sort of look at the older generation that's in supply chain management, a lot of them didn't have supply chain degrees. So if you look at our faculty, most of us that are in the supply chain program don't have supply chain degrees because it just wasn't a thing that many years ago in the university setting. So we had students who were coming through the management program, maybe coming through getting their MBA, that took electives in supply chain management and ended up in supply chain fields in their professional companies. And they are our greatest resource. So they do all kinds of things for us. They support us just in terms of sort of telling the university, hey, you need to get a supply chain program. You need to promote your supply chain program because we need to hire supply chain students. They help us with curriculum. So they look at the courses that we'll sort of go forward with a proposal and ask employers to say, here's the classes that we're thinking about teaching. Do these make sense? And we have alumni that will help us all the way down to the exercise level. So even within a class, when we say, here's a homework assignment that I found in a textbook or that I was thinking about giving, we have alumni that will say, that homework assignment's pretty good, but let me tell you what's a little bit more practical. They feed us data where we can do exercises with real data. Guest speakers, we have guest speakers in a lot of our supply chain classes. Tours, so that's one of the big things in supply chain. A lot of times we have students that say, I want to take a class where you do tours. So we do a lot of tours because we have alumni out there working in these companies that say, hey, if you want to bring a group of supply chain students, we'd love to show them around.
Wow, another great program of the Jones College of Business. Professor, thanks for joining us and congratulations on the phenomenal growth and the excitement around this program.
Thanks for having me.